Let's read out the question.
A portfolio manager has the following four stocks in his portfolio: security, number of shares, market price, pressure, and beta. VSL 10,000 shares, market price 50, and beta 0.9. CSL 5,000 shares, market price pressure 20, and beta 1. SML 8,000 shares, 25 market price pressure, beta 1.5. APL 2,000 shares, market price pressure 200, and beta 1.2. Compute the following portfolio beta. Second, if the PM seeks to reduce the beta to 0.8, how much risk-free investment should he bring in? Third, if the PM seeks to increase the beta to 1.2, how much risk-free investment should he bring in?
See, the problem is all about the three numbers. Okay, number one, they're asking us to find out the portfolio beta. Second one, from whatever portfolio beta we could achieve, it is said that it needs to reduce the beta. So therefore, the portfolio beta is expected to be greater than 0.8. In the third case, if the portfolio manager seeks to increase the beta to 1.2, that means our portfolio beta is expected to be between 0.8 and 1.2. So let us just look into. Say, I would like to come to this. So I would like to compute and demonstrate the two computation rather than doing it from say we understand the game to the problem. Now I will share this module. Where the securities are, yes, and numbers are 10,000, 9,000, 8,000, and 2,000. The prices are 50, 20, 25, and 0. So, four value simply the product of this. So now let us just know about the proportion. Proportion is 50,000 upon 3 lakhs. So the respective betas are 0.9, 1, 1.5. What beta is simply the product of the beta. It comes to 1.1083. Normally, it will be restricted to two decimals. So we can restrict that to two decimal products. 1.11 or 1.108. You can have it to 3 decimals. So we have answered to the first part of the question. Portfolio. Yeah, we have just got it. Now, second question is that what should be done if portfolio beta is to be reduced to 0.8. Okay, that means the investor is, this covers, he feels that it is 1.108 is too much for him to bear. And for him, it is 0.8 is acceptable. What are the ways in which he can go? So the ways in which he can go is that he can dispose of riskier securities and bring in risk-free securities. This is one option he has got. Next one is that he can enter into futures contract with selling strategy. Third one is that he can invest afresh without disturbing the existing portfolio. He can invest afresh without disturbing the existing portfolio so that the overall beta is reduced to 0.2. So these are the ways he has got. Now we are going to rule out the possibility. He can dispose of riskier securities and bring in risk-free security. Now the problem is that he understands that the riskier security is SML, which has got the highest beta 1.5. So how much to dispose of? And in disposal, we will be using some amount of investable amount in the form of transaction cost, brokerage, etc. So therefore, that should not be the case. Maybe that we are ruling out. There is no indication in the problem regarding how much the futures price, whether it is Nifty or BSE or any other index, equity index, they are not mentioned. So therefore, that is also ruled out. Third one, we shall assume, but always remember, in order to assume that somebody is bringing in cash, you cannot bring out an assumption, the other person should use that authority to do. So even at intermediate level, when we talk something about a new partner is bringing in so much of money, or existing partner is bringing in so much of money, so that this profit sharing ratio and capital ratio are matching, would mean it should be provided in the problem that he has got cash and he is bringing in such cash. I cannot assume that Nitesh, Rajagopalan, Karthikeyan or Hemant are bringing in cash. So I cannot assume. It is only Hemant has got to tell that he has to bring in cash, then he will bring in cash. It is only Karthikeyan has got to tell that he will bring in cash. It is Rajagopalan has got to tell that he is bringing in cash. I cannot assume that somebody will bring in cash. But we are forced to bring up that sort of assumption only, even though it may not be ethical to say that somebody has got to bring in cash, but we don't have any other book. Now, what we have got to do is that, so here is a place that for computation sake, I just taken up. Now, I will take up another screen. So in this screen, I would like to explain as how things will move. What is that? So the existing portfolio, if I contrast P, whose beta is 1.10 plus the other proportion where risk-free security, whose beta is going to be zero, the portfolio of these two should give you 0.80. Since it is zero, it will not have any impact at all. So P is equal to 0.80 divided by 1.108. So how much it comes to? This 0.8 divided by 1.108. That comes to 0.7220. That is 72.20 represents existing portfolio. That means the figure of 12 lakhs is representing 72.20% of the total size. So 12 lakhs divided by 0.722 is equal to total investment. So total investment is going to be 12 lakhs divided by 0.722. That should give you the number of, see, if you pick up the fullest with the help of calculator, what you just get is 16,62,000. I am just getting that number only. 16,62,000 exact figure I am getting. Okay, what you do is that, very simple. You take the calculator, all of you. What you do is that 0.8 divided by 1.108. You get a number, no? Memory plus 12 lakhs divided by memory recall. What you get is 16,62,000 round figure you are getting. So original intention of the paper secretary is like that way only. So total investment, existing investment is 12 lakhs. So how much more he has got to invest? 4,62,000 investing risk-free security. I normally tell you in the class that when you are taking bath, while in a winter, when you find in a bucket, you find it is really hot water, but you can't take bath in hot water, but warm water. So what is it you should do? Pour in cold water. So this is hot water, this is cold water. Now the total water level at improved, that has become warm water. Thereby you are achieving 0.8 as the beta, and thereby the fear that you are having, that you are having riskier portfolio, is negated. That means you have achieved your objective. Next one is that if the portfolio manager, I hope that things are clear for you. If the portfolio manager seeks to increase the beta to 1.2, how much risk-free investment should we bring in? So our computation will continue to be the same. So P into 1.108 plus 1 minus P into 0 equal to 1.2. Instead of 0.8, I am making out as 1.2. So what is that we are expected to do? So this is going to be 0. P is equal to 1.20 divided by 1.108. How much it comes to? Let us take the calculator and the sticker. 1.2 divided by 1.108. That comes to 108.30. Sorry. 1.0830. This is what you just get. That means your existing portfolio. Existing portfolio 12 lakhs equal to 108.30%. That means what should be the total portfolio size? Like how we have just got 16,62,000. Here it will get reduced. Don't worry about that. 12 lakhs divided by 108.30%. So I would like to keep this 1.2 divided by 1.108. Memory plus 12 lakhs divided by this should give me a number which is a round number I am just getting. Please understand, I have just beaten the decimal to the fullest extent. Total portfolio size should be 11,08,000. Please just check up. I am not rounded off here. I have retained the fullest amount. So 11,08,000. So what is your existing portfolio? Existing portfolio is 12 lakhs. That means opposite of investment is disinvestment or divestment. Disinvestment, when you just make, you are expected to borrow. So borrow 92,000 and invest with your money of 11,08,000 to make up this 12 lakhs. So now let us just confirm this through our Excel computation. Just see how do we do that. So I have already got this table ready. Copying and putting it here. Discovery. How much is the amount that I got to invest? I got to invest in the first case 4,62,000. 4,62,000. And I got to bring out the total here. And here the proportion is going to be 5 lakhs divided by 16,62,000. So here it is going to be 0. Now let us effect the total. How much you get? You end up with 0.80. So this is the check for question. Now let us just take up check for question number 3. So I would like to bring in this fashion, same copying, risk free security minus 92,000. So minus 92,000. Here it is going to be 5 lakhs divided by this number. Now you see that beta level and this increased from 1.108 to 1.20. So we can confirm our answer as correct in this fashion. Yeah.
Yeah. The following data relate to A Limited's portfolio. Shares X Limited, Y Limited, Z Limited. Number of shares in lakhs. X Limited 6 lakhs, Y Limited 8 lakhs, Z Limited 4 lakhs. And the price per share is, for X Limited share, it is 1000 rupees. Y Limited 1500, Z Limited 500 rupees. A beta of X Limited 1.5, Y Limited 1.3, Z Limited 1.7. The CEO is of the opinion that the portfolio is carrying a very high risk as compared to the market risk and hence interested to reduce the portfolio systematic risk to 0.95.
I will change.
Treasury manager has suggested two below mentioned alternative strategies. First one is dispose of a part of his existing portfolio to acquire risk-free securities. Or the second option is take appropriate position in Nifty futures currently trading at 8,250. And each Nifty points multiplier is rupees 210. You are required to interpret the opinion of CEO whether it is right or correct or not. Second question is calculate the existing systematic risk of portfolio and then advise the value of risk-free securities to be acquired. Then advise the number of shares of each company to be disposed of. Advise the position to be taken in Nifty futures and determine the number of Nifty contracts to be bought or sold and calculate the new systematic risk of portfolio if the company has taken position in Nifty futures and there is 2% rise in Nifty. Notice make calculation in rupees, lakhs and up to 2 decimal points.
Right. See, the problem runs through 3 slides. See, they have given 3 asset portfolio. X Limited, Y Limited and Z Limited in those companies, they have made investment. So much of investment in terms of number of shares, price and the respective beta they have provided. The CEO is of the opinion that the portfolio is carrying a very high risk because all the companies' beta are very high, 1.5, 1.3 and 1.7. And he is interested to reduce the portfolio, portfolio risk to 0.95. So he has got a fear that that much of risk he cannot assume. Treasury manager has suggested two below mentioned alternatives. Dispose of the existing portfolio to acquire risk-free security. So this is what I was just telling in the last problem. You dispose of riskier security, and in that position, you can bring in risk-free security. That is correct. Then another one is that take appropriate position. This is what you have got to be very careful. Appropriate position is what they are given. So what is appropriate is left to the discretion of the reader. So if you are already holding by underlying asset, would mean you have to take up the opposite position in futures. That means you have to sell futures. Currently, which is trading at 8250 with the quantity multiplier, actually it should be, this one should be rupees and this one 210 should be in quantity. But anyway, so when you bring out a product, that is not going to matter. You are required to interpret the opinion of CEO, whether it is correct or not. Say, interpret the opinion. Yes, the CEO is telling that it is very high risk, correct only, because all the beta, that is all the shares beta or beta of all the shares are very high. So it is correct only. So there is no computation involved. So therefore, our delivery of lecture itself is the answer here. Interpret the opinion, whether it is correct or not. Yes, it is correct because all the securities are having high beta. Calculate the existing systematic risk for the portfolio. So this has got to be done, say, in Excel format as we have just done. So now let me just calculate that. And for that sake, I am just taking up Excel now for sharing the position. So we understand that securities are X, Y, and Z. Their numbers are 6 lakhs, 8 lakhs, and 4 lakhs. Their prices are 1,000, 1,500, and simply 500. So what is the portfolio value? Is simply the product. So like how we have just done proportion, 6,000 upon 20,000. So the respective beta, they are given as 1.5, 1.3, and 1.7. So now let us just take up port beta. Port beta is proportion multiplied by the beta. So it becomes 1.40, correct. So we are reading the second question, calculate the existing systematic risk of the portfolio. Now I will share that particular question. I stop here and I share the PPT there. So second question we have answered, calculate the existing systematic risk of the portfolio. The systematic risk of the portfolio is 1.4. Advise the value of risk-free securities to be acquired. So how do we take up the position? So when we are expected to reduce it to, that is, let me just find out, is there any target number they have given? So it is only through, what should I say, theory we can communicate. Advise the value of risk-free security to be acquired. So they are not given us any target beta. So target beta here they have mentioned as to 0.95. Yes, I was just only expecting that. I was searching for that. He wanted to reduce it to 0.95. So how is that we can get into that target 0.95? So here I will take up Windows journal for the purpose of showing the computation. So now we will share that screen. Yes. So now let us just take up that computation. So this is the third part of the question. Target beta is 0.95. Existing beta is 1.40. Correct. So without futures, how is that we will be in a position to do it? So by selling riskier security and bringing in risk-free security, or don't disturb the existing portfolio, keep that amount of 20 lakhs as such, and like how the last problem we have worked out, same way we can take it up. So now existing portfolio P into 1.40 plus 1 minus P into 0 equal to 0.95. So this is going to be 0. So P is equal to 0.95 divided by 1.40. So it is 0.95 divided by 1.4. That should give you is equal to 0.6786. So existing portfolio is equal to 20,000 lakhs, which is representing 0.6786 of the total size. So 20 lakhs divided by 0.6786. So this comes to 29,472. So therefore, risk-free securities will be 9,472. This is one alternative. So remember the Excel that we have just given the alternative. I was just telling you can dispose riskier securities and bring in risk-free securities. Okay, that also I'm going to take up in this particular case. How do we do that? Just watch. Alternative two is that, so when 67.86% represented by riskier securities, 32.14% representing risk-free security. Correct. So therefore, what we can do is that our 20,000 lakhs can be split as riskier and risk-free. It is 20,000, not 2,000, 20,000. It is 20,000 only. So riskier will be 0.6786 into 20,000. That comes to 13,572 there. And this is going to be 6,428. So you can just go to that extent and work it out. So how do we try this. So this is the way they have just indicated in the question. What is that they have indicated in the question? Advise the number of shares on each of the company has got to be disposed of. So how we have taken up this lead is that the fourth question was based on that. So how do we take up this? So this much I got to dispose of. I have to dispose of and bring in this free security. So securities that we have got to take up are, we can't target one particular security and sell it off. So when all the three were to be there in a particular proportion, we sell it off in the same proportion as they are arranged. Proportion in which they are arranged are 0.6, 0.3, 0.6 and 0.1. So sell. So selling should result in 6428. So 6428 into 0.3. It is 1928.40 into 2. It is going to be 3856.80. 642.80. So where the market price per share were to be 1,000, 1,500 and 500. These items are given in the problem. These are all rupees in lakhs. So number of shares sold is going to be 1928.40 lakhs divided by 1,000. Would mean the number of shares that we are selling will be 1,92,840. Similarly, 3856.80 lakhs divided by 1,500. 3856.80 into lakhs divided by 1,500. That should give you not a wrong figure, 257113. The last one, 642.80 lakhs divided by 500. 642.8 into lakhs divided by 500 would mean it comes to 128,516. So this way we have answered to question number D. So this is what I have proposed in the first question itself. So I am not knowing about somebody's liquidity. With the existing liquidity, I got to arrange with me. I got to sell off some and bring in new. This is what we are got to understand. Shall we proceed to the next one? Now let's just go through the question. So up to D we have completed. Now E and F are the two things that we have got to address. What is it? Advise the position to be taken in Nifty futures and determine the number of Nifty contracts to be bought or sold. Okay, this is item number E. Now I will shift to Windows Journal. So here, I know a formula to be used. What is that? So number of futures contract to be, number of futures contract to be sold. They said appropriate action to be sold. How come? So from 1.40 to 0.95, I got to bring in. So we have a strategy like if underlying asset is buy or hold in futures, you have got to sell. Correct? This is the strategy. And we have a formula for this. Portfolio value into beta 2 minus beta 1 divided by value of one futures contract. So as part of step number 1, value of one futures contract equal to 8,250 into 210 should give you 17,32,500. Keep that in your computation. Step number of futures contract to be sold is equal to your portfolio value is 20,000 lakhs multiplied by 0.95. Beta 2 stands for new beta. That is your target beta. Beta 1 is the old beta. 0.95 minus 1.40 divided by 17,32,500. Please understand, this is in terms of lakhs when you compute. Put that lakhs into your computation. Don't put it out as 20,000 only. So now let me just pick up 20,000 into lakhs into 0.45 negative divided by 17,32,500. So what is the number that you end up with? Negative 519.48 contracts. So that to the nearest number, I will make it out as 519 contracts short. Correct. So thus we have answered to item number E. Now I will confirm that we have completed item number E. Advise the position to be taken. What position to be taken up? Short position you got to take up. How many contracts? Determine the number of contracts. That also we have just clearly noted 519. Now, item number F. Calculate the new systematic risk of the portfolio. If the company has taken position in Nifty futures and there is 2% rise in Nifty, make calculation rupees in lakhs and up to 2 decimal points. So this note is only for the last part of the question. Say now, let me stop sharing here and take up two Windows journal whereby I will explain. So the PPT what they've just given is cutting short so many working notes and straight away arriving at the answer. It is going to take a little extra time. For me, I can understand, no problem. For a student to understand, it is going to take time. So it is item number F we are taking up now. So all of you closely follow. So the way in which I am going to work out is the way in which I have solved a problem in the class. So strategy is SF1. Underlying asset and futures. If you take up as a combination pool hedge, in the spot, if you have just bought, you have got to sell for the purpose of hedging, because your strategy is for hedging, not for speculation. So opposite position you got to take up. So at maturity, you are expected to sell and here you are expected to buy. Correct? This is the strategy. Now, at maturity, what had happened? At maturity, in the case of underlying asset and in the case of futures, we will bring it forward by 20,000 lakhs. Correct? And here, sell 8,250. Correct. So at maturity, what has happened is that they've said 2% rise in the Nifty. So 2% rise in the Nifty would mean what will happen to the underlying asset. So underlying asset has got a beta of, no, I just forgotten that. So let me just stick up. See, I know our beta is 1.40. Am I right? So if there is in market, when it is happening one, in this portfolio, it will happen 1.40. Correct. So this is the ideal scenario. Correct. Whatever changes that is happening in the market when it is one, in portfolio it will be 1.4. That is the beta. So in the market happened would mean 2% means. So this is going to be 2.80. This is what we have got to understand. How come 2 divided by 1 into 1.40? So now at maturity, what will happen is that 20,000 into 1.0280, or I would say it is 20,000 plus 2.80% into 20,000. How much it is going to be now? ₹20,560 lakhs. So in futures, it is by 8,250 plus 8,250 into 2%. So here it gave me 2.8, and there in the market it is going to be 2%. How much is that?
8,415.
So the result is going to be profit or loss. The result is 560 profit without brackets. So here it is going to be 165 within brackets. So numbers, number of units. So since it is rupees and number only one. So here how much I will pick up? So 210 is the quantity multiplied by 519. What is 519? This is the quantity. This is the number of contracts. So where we have just got the number of contracts? Number of contracts, 590. Correct. So this much is the number. This is the price. That is what I told you, no? See, in the question, they have wrongly given that. So 210 into 590. So it is 1,08,990. So now they have got to multiply. So overall result is going to be 560 lakhs. And here it is going to be 165 into 108,990 into 165. This comes to 179.83 lakhs, because they have asked us to pick it up only for 2 decimal position. So rounded off to 2 decimals. So am I right? So how do you get it? This is quantity and this is number, rupees. So when you multiply, it comes to 179.8335. Am I right? Now, this is negative. So, what is going to be your overall result? So, overall result is 560 minus 179.83. That comes to 380.17 as the profit. Now, you please understand that the percentage of gain is going to be 380.17 divided by 20,000 into 100 divided by 20,000 in percentage. It comes to 1.90. So this is the change in portfolio. So change in market is 2%. Am I right? So now, what is the beta now? Beta is equal to percentage change in portfolio divided by percentage change in market. Remember that for beta, this is the number 1.90 divided by 2, where you get your target beta of 0.95, you are in a position to achieve. So mark this problem as very, 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 very important for your examination. Okay. So this question, I consider as really great. See, not because it is difficult, but the way in which we have presented as the same as we have done in the class. So go through our institute PPT, that is institute material and RTP and all that. But let me tell you, this in the recent past, I would consider that it is one of the best problems that we are having. So that is the way this problem is getting over. Yes, we are just there. Can you just see that?
Yes, sir. Right Limited has proposed to expand its operations for which it requires funds of $30 million. Net of issue expenses, which amount to 4% of the issue size. It proposed to raise the funds through a GDR issue. It considers the following factors in pricing the issue. The expected domestic market price of the share is Rs. 300. Face value is 10 per share. Four shares underlying each GDR. Underlying shares are priced at 20% discount to the market price. Expected exchange rate is 70 per dollar. You are required to compute the number of GDRs to be issued and cost of GDR Right Limited. 20% dividend is expected to be paid with a growth rate of 20%.
Right. See, here, not much of a computation is involved, but one thing that you have got to understand is that I require a fund of 20, 30 million with a net of, that is flotation cost of 4% to me. So I can understand that I got to raise for a higher face value so that 4% I sacrifice towards flotation expenses and thereby I am just getting 30 million. So therefore, I will just share this Windows journal where I will tell us how much we got to raise. So question number four, if my gross value is 100, flotation cost when it is 4, net realization 96. When I want 30 million, how much should be the gross issue? Gross issue should be 30 million divided by 96 into 100. So how much it comes to? 31.25. So this is the first working note that we got to develop. So now I will show it in the screen itself. I mean, in PPT itself. So we understand that it is gross issue is 31.25. Now all of you closely follow as you know that 4 shares will make 1 GDR. I hope that all of you would be knowing that GDR concept, global depository receipt. So if an Indian company, when it is listed in Indian securities market, they can as well raise money in foreign securities market by keeping whatever may be the number according to their what should I say proposal. Here they say 4 shares will make 1 GDR. And that is what you find in this particular case, 300 into 4. What is 300 there? 300 is the price of 1 share in India for that particular company. So 300 into 4 into 80%. What is this 80% indicating for you? So here, underlying shares are priced at 20% discount to the market price. See, in order to make this GDR attractive, so they normally offer at a price less than the market price. So it is the same concept as rights issue that you have. Say when rights issue is made, the company will price it at less than the market price. Same concept, but here the discount is a little
more in this particular case. So thereby, each GDR is expected to be priced at 960. So 300 into 4,200 into 80% 960. So this is in Indian term, that is Indian rupee, where $1 is going to be costing 70 rupees. So what is the pricing in terms of dollars? That comes to 13.71, isn't it? And you understand by going through the problem that 20% is the dividend expected to be paid with a growth rate of 20%. So as of now, on 10 rupees being the face value, 20% on 10 rupees will work out to 2. That is the reason as why it is 2 here. And why it is multiplied by 4 is because of 4 shares will make 1 GDR. So 8 rupees is the dividend per GDR. So therefore, you have got D1. So net proceeds will be 921.60. How come? From 960, by applying that 4% flotation cost, so it will net realization is going to be 921.60. So coming to the next slide, so you understand the number of GDR or number of GDR to be issued is 31.25 million dollar you have to raise, and each one will be priced at 13.71 as you find here. So therefore, the number of GDR that you have got to issue will be 2.2794 million. Because the question did carry as how many number of GDRs to be issued. So we have answered to that question as 2.2794 million. So the next question that we read is, what is the cost of the GDR? So like how we have in the case of equity, so where we have cost of equity KE is equal to D1 divided by P0 plus G. Same way in this particular case, it is 8 rupees. That being the dividend divided by 921.60 net of all these issue expenses plus 0.20. So this being the cost of this particular GDR. So A divided by 921.6 plus 0.2. So that gives you the cost as 20.87%. So that is the way we could see the final answer coming up at 20.87. So with that, the space that we have just completed with this 3 questions. So I would rate the second question that we have solved as the best. And first, of course, we can just consider as not a very great problem. Second problem is very good. This last problem, I consider as any GDR problem. So with that, this session is coming to an end. And if you have any doubt or any clarification that you are seeking, you can raise now. Yes. So you can raise the point now. Participants, I find are Hemant, Karthikeyan, Meera.
No doubt, sir.
So no doubt. How about Karthikeyan and Meera?
No doubt, sir.
No doubt. Yeah. So Meera is not reachable. So maybe she would have just chatted. No doubt. So, okay. So with that, we will be just meeting the next week. If you have any other, difficult moments in attending to the class and all that, you can just communicate to me. I will just take it to the appropriate forum. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Right. Thank you. Bye. So, Nitesh.
Thank you, sir.
Your class is over.